In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Today we have, in the beginning of the Gospel, the most translated passage in the Bible, John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he sent his only Son to save. For God so loved the world that he sent Jesus his Son to save you and me. So we open our lives to God's salvation plan, his rescue plan, made visible, made flesh in Jesus Christ his Son. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you came to bring us your peace. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. As we recall year by year the mysteries by which through the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again, we earnestly beseech your mercy, O Lord, what we celebrate in faith, we may possess in an ending love. We make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is a reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The high priest intervened with all his supporters from the party of the Sadducees. Prompted by jealousy, they arrested the apostles and had them put in the common jail. But at night, the angel of the Lord opened the prison gates and said, as he led them out, "Go and stand in the temple and tell the people all about this new life." They did as they were told. They went into the temple at dawn and began to preach. When the high priest arrived, he and his supporters convened the Sanhedrin, this was the full Senate of Israel, and sent to the jail for them to report. But when the officials arrived at the prison, they found they were not inside. So they went back and reported. We found the jail securely locked, and the warders on duty at the gates. But when we unlocked the door, we found no one inside. The captain of the temple and the chief priests heard this news. They wondered what this could mean. Then a man arrived with fresh news. At this very moment, he said, the men who were imprisoned are in the temple. They are standing there, preaching to the people. The captain went with his men and fetched them. They were afraid to use force in case the people stole them. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The response is, this poor man called, and the Lord heard him. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. I will bless the Lord at all times, his praise always on my lips. In the Lord my soul shall make its boast, the humble shall hear and be glad. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. Glorify the Lord with me. Together let us praise his name. I saw the Lord, he answered me. From all my terrors, he set me free. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. Look towards him and be radiant. Let your faces not be abashed. This poor man called, the Lord heard him, and rescued him from all his distress. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. The angel of the Lord is encamped around those who revere him to rescue them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. He is happy eternal life. For God sent his Son into the world not to condemn the world, but so that through him the world might be saved. No one who believes in him will be condemned, but whoever refuses to believe is condemned already, because he has refused to believe in the name of God's only Son. On these grounds his sentence pronounced, that though the light has come into the world, men have shown they prefer darkness to light, because their deeds were evil. And indeed, everybody who does wrong hates the light and avoids it, for fear his actions should be exposed. But the man who lives by the truth comes out into the light, so that it may be plainly seen that what he does is done in God. The Gospel. If you have ever stayed in a hotel room, you may be familiar with the Gideon Bible. If you've got a bit bored, sat in a hotel room for a look and see what's in the doors. In many hotels, you will find a copy of the Gideon Bible, placed there by the Gideon Society. And in the front of that Bible, certainly one of the copies I've seen, it has the verse John 3:16 translated into many different languages. Huge number of languages. You see this phrase, for God so loved the world that he sent his only Son to save us. And that's very appropriate because the incarnation, Son of God becoming flesh, is God's ultimate act of translation of his love. To love us in a way that we can understand by becoming one of us. So God knows how we feel. And if you look in the front of the Gideon Bible, you'll find that there are suggested scripture passages for all the different feelings that we might have in life, to remind us that God is with us. Well, this piece of scripture is so important for us, whatever emotions and feelings we might be feeling today, this moment in the lockdown. However we're feeling, for God so loved the world that he sent his only Son to save us. God so loved the world, he sent Jesus his Son so that he can be with you throughout this day. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual food. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in the sacrament, have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the light of all who has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together in any hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word of my soul shall be healed. Behalf of everyone, a prayer in the spiritual communion prayer of St. Alphonsus. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I passionately desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my soul, so that I may unite myself wholly to you, now and forever. Let us pray. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice, graciously be present to your people, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Today at 12:30, we will be live streaming Mass for the children and the families, particularly from St. Joseph's, but of all families, because tomorrow is St. Thomas Canterbury. Joshua will be making an appearance in the homily. So if you have family coming, especially from St. Joseph's, we'll say, come on, 12:30, get online and join that Mass. It'll be lovely. We've started our virtual pilgrimage to Lourdes. Thank you to everybody who's joined us so far. A couple of issues with the music, but I've got a plan, so I think we're going to sort it out today. But generally we'll be there. We'll be there again. We've got this afternoon, 4:00, joining a HCPT Mass, which will be very special. So 4:00, and then 10:00 this evening. The
Morning, everyone.